Good evening, everybody. Mahume, kya hua? So you were second person? Now, in my last lecture, I had already explained you about the concept of work. Work in the sense of physics, work in the sense of mechanics. And I had conceptualized it as F dot S. Force vector dot displacement vector, that is work. Alag alag cases mein. Force ko resolve karna, displacement ko resolve karna, force ko kaise treat karna. Yah sari cheeze maine batai thi. Aur work determine karne ke alag alag tarike bataye the. When we have got system of force, multiple forces, toh kaise kare? When we have got variable force, tab kaise work nikale? Yah sari cheez main mere pichle lecture mein samjha chuka tha. Maine work ka unit, work ka dimension formula, yah sari cheez batai thi. Now, I'll continue the same topic. My next article is work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. Bilkul simple si baat hai. Whatever is work done on the system, that is change in internal energy. Work done by the external force on the system is change in internal energy. External forces ke dwara jitna bhi work hoega, or work done by all the forces, or work done by the forces is change in internal energy. This is work energy theorem. Work done by haji volume increase karu nahi mahu mein in the acha current acha theek hai main isi samay karwata hu wo to wahi par jo amplifier rakha hai na usse fatafat karne ka bolo ek baar kusum please niche tha na nahi jinko bulana unse bolna the same baat ha jahan sharma ji the na unse work done by the forces is change in energy of the system. This is work energy theorem. Work done is delta E, or work done is E2 minus E1. This is work energy theorem. And आगे के chapter में हर जगह पर हम यह work energy theorem भी apply करेंगे. Volume increase करो 202. आगे के पूरे chapter में वह amplifier से भी कर सकते हो शायद. पूरे chapter में हम work energy theorem apply करेंगे और अलग अलग cases को समझेंगे. जैसा मैंने बताया है कि in fact मैं पिछली बार भी बोल रहा था कि जब हम वर्क करते हैं, इट मींस वी आर एडिंग, वी आर पुटिंग सम एनर्जी इनटू द सिस्टम. हम उस सिस्टम के अंदर एनर्जी डाल रहे हैं. जैसे यह कोई ब्लॉक है, इस ब्लॉक पर एक्सटर्नल फोर्स लगता है. इस एक्सटर्नल फोर्स के लगने से यह ब्लॉक एक्सीलरेट होता है और यह ब्लॉक मूव करने लगता है, कुछ वेलोसिटी में पर आ जाता है. When this block moves from this place to this place, when this block acquires some velocity, when this block changes its velocity, there is some work done. This is the displacement. That work is done by the force. Now, work done by the force would look at, means there must be some agent. Koi external agent hoga, jo force laga raha hoga, jo khinch raha hoga. Wo jo agent hai, wahan work kar raha hai. Means that agent is putting energy into it. मैं यदि खींच रहा हूं तो मैं अपने अंदर से एनर्जी इस बॉडी के अंदर डाल रहा हूं और वर्क के रूप में डाल रहा हूं और मेरे द्वारा डाली गई एनर्जी अब इस बॉडी के पास दिखने लगेगी इन वेरियस फॉर्म्स. वी हैव गॉट डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ एनर्जी. After explaining work, energy theorem, my next article would be the concept of energy. We have got different forms of energy. Energy kai roop mein kisi bhi body ke andar dikhti hai, dikh sakti hai. And sabse pehle jo main samjhaunga, that is kinetic energy of any system. My next article is the concept of kinetic energy. We used to say whenever a body is moving, whenever the particle is moving, due to its motion it possesses some energy. That energy possessed by any particle due to its motion is termed as kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is defined as energy possessed by the body due to its motion. Hum kehte hain sleeping man have got less energy while a dancing person have got more energy. Jo person dance kar raha hai, his limbs, his body is in motion, uske alag alag part alag alag tarike se move kar rahe hain, and it possess energy due to motion and we call it kinetic energy. While a sleeping man जिसका कोई मोशन नहीं हो रहा है, वी यूज टू से दैट इट हैव गॉट नो एनर्जी और लेस एनर्जी. अब मैं इसी काइनेटिक एनर्जी को सबसे पहले कंसेप्चुलाइज करना चाहता हूं, इसके लिए एक्सप्रेशन ऑब्टेन करना चाहता हूं, इसके लिए एक्सप्रेशन लिखना चाहता हूं. एंड द लॉजिक दैट आई विल अप्लाई वुड बी वर्क एनर्जी थियोरम. हम एक स्टेशनरी बॉडी ले लेते हैं. दिस इज अ स्टेशनरी पार्टिकल. अ स्टेशनरी पार्टिकल. इफ अ पार्टिकल इज स्टेशनरी, इट्स वेलोसिटी इज जीरो, इट्स इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो, इट्स इनिशियल काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज जीरो. Apply a force on this body and due to that force this body starts moving. मैं इस पर फोर्स लगाता हूं और इस फोर्स के लगाने से यह बॉडी मूव होने लगी, यह एक्सीलरेट होने लगेगी. इफ दिस पार्टिकल हैव गॉट मास ऑफ m, वी नो दैट द एक्सीलरेशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल वुड बी गिवन बाय force is equal to mass into acceleration, or acceleration would be force upon mass. Now this force acts for some time t, and during that time interval the body got displaced by some finite displacement s and it acquires some velocity. यह बॉडी इस फोर्स की वजह से यहां तक आ जाती है. यह फोर्स टी टाइम के लिए एक्ट करा एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस टाइम टी द बॉडी गॉट डिस्प्लेस्ड बाय एस. इट्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज एस. And after getting displaced after time t, the body acquires some velocity v. This is the final velocity v. Now, I will apply work energy theorem. I will say initially the particle was at rest, kinetic energy was zero. But after time t, the particle is started moving. Yah particle move karne laga hai. And due to that motion, the particle now possesses some energy. Final kinetic energy value. And I wish to determine this finite value of kinetic energy. मैं kinetic energy की यह finite value ही determine करना चाहता हूँ. And in order to do this, I'll apply work energy theorem, which says that work done is change in energy. Now here I say there is the change in only kinetic energy of the body. Energy is changing in the form of kinetic energy. और कोई सी भी energy का परिवर्तन मैं नहीं देख रहा हूँ. मैं सिर्फ kinetic energy में ही परिवर्तन देख रहा हूँ. मैं सिर्फ एक body जो rest में थी, उसको v velocity से move होते हुए देख रहा हूँ. तो मैं कहता हूँ work done is final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. अब work done is F dot S. Final kinetic energy, I wish to determine initial kinetic energy is zero. Now, we used to say S, I can determine this, the value of S. V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. I will apply that equation. V square is equal to U square. पहले मैं equation लिखता हूँ, फिर value substitute करता हूँ. That would be better. V square is equal to U square plus 2 AS. V square ऐसा कैसा ही U square is zero. 2 acceleration की जगह force upon mass into displacement. And I will write it in this manner. Displacement is half m v square by f. And now substitute this displacement, this equation. By displacement ko is equation mein substitute karta hu. Final kinetic energy is F dot S. Since force and displacement vector are collinear, they are in same direction, the angle between them is zero, the value of cos theta would be 1. It would be force into displacement, so force into half mv square by F, F say F cancelled. Kinetic energy possessed by body is half m v square. Although I am very much sure कि आप सभी को यह expression already पता है. Any particle moving with velocity v having mass m have got kinetic energy of half mv square. Let me conclude it here. Kinetic energy of any particle having finite mass m and velocity v have got kinetic energy of half mv square. But dot E is a vector quantity. We are writing an expression of kinetic energy, although it's a scalar quantity. An expression for kinetic energy written in terms of some vector quantity. It means there must be some vector relationship for this equation. And let me write that exact vector relationship. It's exact vector relationship is half n into v dot v. Vector v dot vector v. Any particle having mass of m moving with some velocity v, we used to say that this particle possesses some momentum, and momentum is the scalar multiple of mass into velocity. Momentum is the scalar multiple of mass into velocity. We used to say the most basic definition of kinetic energy is half P dot V. This is how we conceptualize kinetic energy of any body. Half P dot V. P is the momentum. It's a scalar multiple of mass into velocity. P ki jagah maine mv likha, half m into v dot v. This velocity vector, dot velocity vector, they would be collinear, angle between them would be zero. This v dot v should be written in this manner. V dot v would be mod v cos of 0 degree, or this is equal to v square. This would be v dot v, and this is how we conceptualize kinetic energy of any body. Now, after conceptualizing work energy theorem, after conceptualizing kinetic energy, now let me introduce a new definition, a new concept, the concept of power. Power ka concept likhne se pehle ek baar main kinetic energy ki unit bhi bata dun. The CGS unit of kinetic energy and the SI unit of kinetic energy. We used to say this kinetic energy would be given in mass ki jagah par kg, velocity ki jagah par meter per second square hai, isliye meter square per second square, or in joules. This is in SI system. Standard international system mein. This would be the unit of kinetic energy. Always remember, 1 joules is always equal to 1 kg meter square per second square. This is the unit of kinetic energy. While in CGS system, this kinetic energy would be given in mass ki jagah grams hoga, gram, velocity ki jagah centimeter per second, velocity square hai, that's why centimeter square per second square. And this CGS unit of kinetic energy, it's ergs. One ergs is equal to 1 gram centimeter square per second square. Now, although FPS system is obsolete system, it's a redundant system, it's never used. उसमें मैं बोल जरूर देता हूं, मगर आप कभी भी उसको इस्तेमाल नहीं करोगे, वहां पर आप काइनेटिक एनर्जी के लिए यूनिट लिखोगे. पाउंड फिट स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर, ऑल्दो नेवर यूज्ड. इधर मैं आपसे एक सवाल जरूर पूछूंगा, कैन यू टेल मी वन इज इक्वल टू हाउ मैनी अर्थ्स. 1 joule is equal to how many ergs?
1
into 10 to the power 7. That's perfect answer. Joule is unit of energy in SI system. Ergs is unit of energy in CGS system. Definitely there must be a relationship. There must be a conversion factor. And one can always obtain that conversion factor from this basic definition. 1 joule जिसको मैंने लिखा है, 1 kg meter square per second square can be written as 1 kilogram की जगह मैं 1000 gram लिखूंगा, 1 meter की जगह मैं लिखूंगा 100 centimeter square और second square. इसी तरह से this becomes 10^7 gram centimeter square per second square, or this is equal to 10^7 ergs. 1 joule is equal to 10^7 ergs.